Hey everybody, Howard Pinsky here with a brand new Photoshop tutorial, and we're going to be doing a little bit of photo composition in today's tutorial. I'm going to be taking this image right here, which I shot a few days ago in Colorado, and I'm going to be transforming it into a mystical mountain range. When I initially shot the photo, it looked great in my camera, but when I took it into Lightroom and I did some toning, it just didn't give me that effect that I was looking for. So I figure instead of just throwing this image in the trash, I'm going to grab some photos from Shutterstock.com, and I'm going to take this image to a whole nother level. And I'm going to end up with something that looks like this. So let's go ahead and begin. Now before I even touch the stock images, I want to make sure to isolate the sky from the rest of the image. That'll allow me to easily grab those stock images of the different skies and put them right behind the mountain range of this image. And to do that, Photoshop has a lot of different selection methods that we can use, but I'm going to use the quick selection tool, which can be found in your tools bar, because I found for situations like this, it works fantastic. It works almost like a brush, where you can actually brush over the areas of your image that you want to turn into a selection. So with my right square bracket key, I'm going to increase the size of my brush and simply start brushing over top of the sky and clouds just like this. And you'll notice we now have the marching ants going across our image, and that indicates that area will become a selection. Now you might notice if I zoom into this area here, some of the mountains were selected as well. So I can easily decrease the size of the brush with my left square bracket key and then hold down my Option key on the Mac or Alt key on Windows and brush in that area to deselect that area. And with my spacebar held down, I can pan the image to see if there are any other areas that need to be deselected. So right over here, there's a little bit of the mountains that were selected, so I can simply hold down my Option key and click, and that area will become deselected. I'm going to pan over to the left over here, and the rest of the mountains are looking pretty nice. And there's one more little area that was selected over here, so I'm going to hold down Option one more time and simply click to deselect. And if I press Command or Control 0, I can see the whole image on my screen. Now at this point we have the sky selected, but we actually want the mountains selected so we can get rid of the sky. It was just easier to select the sky rather than everything else below it. So we want to inverse the selection. We can go up to the Select menu and then Inverse, or we can use the shortcut Command or Control Shift and I. Now once that's done, because we're dealing with trees and a little bit of rock, we want to refine the edge of our selection. This will give us a much more defined and accurate selection than we have right now, which is a little bit sharp and jagged. So right up here we have the Refine Edge feature, which can also be found under the Select menu as well. And I've done a few tutorials on the past of this feature, so I'm not going to go over all the options. But basically right here you have a few different ways on how you can view your result. You can view it as marching ants, which is basically a selection, overlay, on black, on white, black and white, and so on. I prefer the black and white option as it's going to allow me to see exactly how my selection is going to be turning out. And once you have your view set, all we really want to do is turn on Smart Radius and then increase the radius value. And you're going to see if I zoom in over here, we have a much more accurate selection. Photoshop has actually gone in between the trees to make a more accurate and defined selection. So if you're dealing with a subject that contains fur or hair or trees, you'll definitely want to use the Smart Radius feature as the selection will be much more accurate. And when we go ahead and add the stock images behind the mountains, it's almost going to be seamless. So with that set, the only other option that we want to set is the output. I'm going to select Layer Mask, which will allow us to hide that sky in the background, but it won't delete it completely. It's always going to be there if we need it later on. And when I press OK, Photoshop is going to hide that sky, leaving us with only the mountains. One more time, Command 0 or Control 0 to fit the image on my screen. And if I hop over here to my Layers panel, you can see we have that same image, but we now have a layer mask on it, which has hidden the sky. And if I hold down Shift and click on that layer mask, you can see that the sky is still actually there, but it's hidden using that mask. So at this point, we can now go ahead and add those stock images into this image. So I'm going to go over here to this image here. This sky is going to be on the left side of my image. So I'm going to grab my Move tool and simply drag it on top of this document and place it right here. Now initially, it's going to be on top of the mountains, but in the Layers panel, you can simply drag it right below and place it behind the mountains. And of course, you can grab the Move tool again and position it anywhere you like. I'm going to position it right over there. Next, let's go to our next stock image of a night sky. Again, drag it on top of this document and place it right there. And with my Move tool, I can move it anywhere I like. Now, here's something you should take note of. Because we're going to be blending these two skies together, we want the top sky, which in this case is that night sky on the right. We don't want to place it too far to the right because the blending won't look that nice and it won't occur right in the middle. So we want to actually place it a little bit to the left, just right around here, which will give us a little bit of room to blend it with the image in the back and give us a nice transition in the middle of our image. And once you have both skies in place, we want to add a layer mask to this image so we can go ahead and blend them really nicely. So at the bottom of your layers panel, we're going to click on the layer mask icon right here, and it's going to add a blank layer mask, as you can see to the right of this layer. Now to blend it, we're going to be using the gradient tool, which can be found in your tools bar on the left, right over here. And when that's selected, you want to make sure that the second gradient option is selected, which is foreground to transparent. And you want to make sure your foreground color is set to black. Because if you know anything about layer masks, you know that black hides portions of your layer and white reveals it. And when that's set, all you have to do is go to the left side of the top image, which is our night sky, hold down your shift key to constrain that gradient, and drag it to the right. You don't want to go too far, but somewhere right around here. And when you let go, you'll now have a nice transition between the left sky and the night sky. And of course, if you're not happy with it, Command or Control Z to undo, and you can redo it. So in this case, I'm going to again hold down shift and drag it a little bit further to the right to get a little bit more of a transition. And that looks good right there. So at this point, we have the skies in place. We have the left sky, which is a little bit of a dusk sunset type sky, and then the right sky, which is more of a nighttime look. But obviously there's a little bit of a problem. If you take a look at the mountains in the foreground, they don't really match the sky in the background. So we need to fix that. And to do that, we're going to add a few adjustment layers on top of the mountains. So in the layers panel, you want to make sure to have the top layer selected, which in this case is our mountains. And right at the bottom, we're going to add an adjustment layer. The first one we're going to be adding is photo filter. This will allow us to warm up or cool down our layers. But when you first add an adjustment layer, it adds it to all of your layers. What we need to do is clip it to the mountain layer so it only affects the mountains and the grass in the foreground. And that can be done in your properties panel using this icon right here, which will clip it to the layer right below it. So that way it's not going to affect the skies that we have in the background. And you can see in your layers panel, you have a little down arrow indicating that this adjustment layer is clipped to the layer right below it. Now, as for the adjustment itself, we do want a warming filter because we are going to be working on the left side of the image first, and then we're going to move to the right side. And Photoshop does have a few types of warming filters. You can go through and see which one works best, but really you want to increase the density until the mountains become nice and orange, just like this. And if we go down to the bottom of our layers panel and hide it, you can see the difference it's made. So there's the before and there's the after. We now have much warmer mountains. Now they do seem a little bit washed out right now, but we're going to take care of that in the end when we add a final curves adjustment. So don't worry about that too much. We're just worrying about warming it up on the left side and then cooling it down on the right side. But even though we went ahead and clipped this adjustment layer to the mountains below it, the right side of this image, which is supposed to be cool, is now warm. So how do we deal with that? Well, adjustment layers come with a layer mask. If you take a look beside the adjustment layer on the right, you have a blank layer mask. So just like we were able to blend the two skies together, we can use a black gradient to blend out the adjustment layer. So I still have the gradient tool selected, and with the layer mask on the adjustment active, I can go to my document, hold down shift, and drag from the right side of the image to the left. And you'll notice it's gotten rid of the adjustment on the right side of the image, only leaving the warming filter on the left side. So again, if I turn off the filter and back on, you can see that that photo filter is only affecting the left side of the image, which is exactly what I want. So now that that adjustment is done, we're going to add another photo filter to affect the right side of the image. So again, I'm going to bring up my adjustment layers and I'm going to add another photo filter, but this time I want to change it from a warming filter to a cooling filter and then increase the density until it looks nice on the right side of the image, somewhere right around there. Now obviously, just like we did in the last step, we don't want this filter affecting the left side of the image. So with the gradient tool still active and the layer mask selected, I'm going to simply drag out a gradient from around the middle of the document to the right, which will get rid of that cooling filter on the left side, leaving it nice and cool on the right. And of course, just like with the previous adjustment layer that we added, we want to make sure to clip it to the previous layer so that it's not affecting the sky in the background. Good, so at this point, we now have the new skies in the background blended nicely together. We have a sunrise on the left and a night sky on the right. And then on the mountains, we have a nice warming filter on the left and a nice cooling filter on the right. But like I mentioned, the foreground is a little bit washed out. So one thing that I love to do when I'm coming to the end of a project is I love to add a curves adjustment layer just to sharpen up the image and fix some of the tones that may be washed out. So one more time, we're going to grab an adjustment layer. I'm going to grab the curves adjustment layer and simply make some adjustments. I'm going to bring down some of the shadows just like this, bring up the highlights just a little bit, just to sharpen up that image to give it more of a contrast, maybe bring the shadows down just a little bit more, and you can see we no longer have that washed out look. And with this adjustment layer, you may or may not want to clip it. If I go ahead and clip it just to the mountains, the sky is a little bit washed out. It doesn't really match. So I'm going to actually leave it unclipped, which gives us a nice high contrast effect. So looking back at what we've done so far, we started out by removing the sky using selection and refine edge. Then we added those stock images from Shutterstock behind the mountains and we blended them really nicely together using a layer mask. And then we added a few adjustments to add a nice warming effect on the left side and a cooling effect on the right side so that they match the sky in the background. And then we finished it off using a curves adjustment layer to sharpen up the image and give it a nice high contrast effect. And with these same techniques, you can bring in additional images, like this moon over here. I can grab this image here with my move tool, drag it over to this document, and I can add a nice moon to this image. Obviously it's a little bit too big, so I'm gonna enter free transform mode, command or control T, and then command or control 0, so I can see the whole document, including the transform bounds. I'm gonna drag it downwards just a little bit like this, press return or enter to accept, and I'm gonna drag it in my layers panel right below the mountains, and then I can position it where I like. So I'm gonna put it in the top right corner right around here. Now obviously if I fit the image to the screen, you can see that we now have an ugly border around this image of the moon. So how do we fix that? Well, there are a few things you can do, including layer masks and selections, but I'm gonna start with one of my favorite little known features, a feature that a lot of people don't use in Photoshop, and that's Blend If. I'm gonna double click on this layer to bring up my layer styles, and down here at the bottom we have the Blend If section. And in this case, we really wanna suck out some of the shadows of this layer. So down here we have this slider right here, and if I hold down my Option key on the Mac, Alt key on Windows, I can drag the right side of the slider to the right to transition some of the shadows out of this layer. Now you're still gonna have a little bit of a border, but if I press OK, we can easily deal with that using, well, a layer mask. So one more time, just like we've done with all the other layers, I'm gonna add a layer mask, and with my gradient tool, press the G key on the keyboard, I'm gonna simply add a very slight gradient from the left side of this layer, just right around here, to transition that out, and from the bottom, up, which will leave us with a nice seamless moon in the background of our image. And of course, if you need to, all these layers are completely editable, which is a huge advantage of using adjustment layers. So if you go back later on and you decide you want a little bit more contrast in the image, you can simply click on the curves adjustment layer and make changes as needed, just like that. And it's not just the adjustment layers, it's also the mask as well. So if you take a look at your image and notice that the mountains are a little bit rough around the edges, or you want to bring that mask inwards a bit, you can simply click on the layer mask, and in the properties panel, you're going to see the mask properties. And you can actually go ahead and click on mask edge to bring up that dialog box again and make changes as needed. So you can go ahead and shift that edge inwards a little bit if you notice that some of the sky was left over on the mountains. And once you press OK, it's going to apply that change directly to that layer mask. And that just about completes it. Using a few stock images, a few adjustment layers, and some masking, we've taken a pretty mediocre image and completely transformed it into a mystical mountain range. I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. Let me know if you want more tutorials like this. If you want to check out the written version of this tutorial, or you want to download the full res final image of this result, check out my website, iceflowstudios.com. Make sure to subscribe to receive future updates. Follow me on Facebook, Twitter, Google+, all that fun stuff. And until next time, take care.